But the grace of God, today we'll be talking about how do you see the church? How do you see the church? Now, before we talk about how we see the church, there's a need for us to know or understand what is a church. Hallelujah. A church is a place where people gather together to worship God. Oxford Dictionary says a building used for public Christian worship. It is also called the house of God. This is general beliefs and understanding of the church. But biblically, the biblical understanding of the church is different from how we believe or understand the church. Hallelujah. Yeah. Praise Master Jesus. Yeah. Biblically, church is a person. Church is a person. Church is not the building, but the person in the building. That is the reason why we, most of us, we missed it along the way, because we believe that where we go to and worship God is the church. Of course, generally that is the belief and that is the understanding that we have. But the true meaning of the church is you that is the church, not the beauty to go. For example, let's take example this place that we are now. Because we are all here, we call it a church. Immediately we move out of this place and DJ come here and set his musical set here and begin to play music, it becomes a disco hall. Hallelujah. That means it's no longer a church anymore. It's not a disco hall. That means to say it is you that is carrying the church to wheresoever you are. Which means you are the church. The Bible says our body is the temple of the living God. That is where God lives. God lives in the church. That means God lives in you. Hallelujah. It came to a time when Jesus and his disciples were debating. What I mean, they were just explaining to themselves. And Jesus asked them, "Who do men say I am?" And many of them were telling Jesus what they have heard from others. Some say you are the Elijah, some say you are the John the Baptist, some say you are that. But Peter said, "Wait a minute, you are the Christ, the Savior of the world." And Jesus replied to him and said, "Flesh and blood have not revealed this to you, but my Father that is in heaven." Amen. And he said, "You, Peter, upon this rock I will build my church." Now, Jesus was talking about the person of the church. Hallelujah. Amen. So if you want to talk about church, talk about yourself, because you are the church.
Amen.
How you see the church determines how do we treat the church. If you say my church is not good, that means you are not good, because you are the church. But in my church, there are a lot of jealous people. That means you are a jealous person. In my church, they don't express love, which means you don't express love. You are the church, not the beauty. The beauty is just a place. You need to come together and pray to God. The real church, it is us. We are carrying God. God is no longer in heaven. God is not in heaven. God operates for heaven. God operates for heaven. God is not in heaven. Those of us that believe that God is just in one place, sitting down, God is everywhere at the same time. Now, if God is in heaven, the Bible said, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Then, which means God was on the earth before creating the heaven and the earth. Hallelujah. God only operates from heaven. God is in you. You are his temple. He lives in you. He's inside you. You are the church. Stop accusing the building. Stop accusing people around you. Accuse yourself. If the church is not working, you are not working. If the church is not going well, you are not going well. If the church must move forward, you must be the one to stand up for it. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Praise Master Jesus. Hallelujah. You must understand this biblical text that will help you to be able to connect to your Father. When you have this understanding that really I'm at the church, is really sure that I'm the church? Of course! So at the church. Let someone just come to this place now and said, I just carry AK-47. I said, everybody, everybody out of this place. Everybody goes out. Even at this hall become empty. Automatically the church has moved out. It's not remaining just the building. People of God, let's change our mentality. Let's change the way we think. Let's change the way we do things. It will help our future. It will help our children. It will help where we are going. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Church is the foundation of human existence. That is my belief. I believe I came from the church. I'm returning back to the church because at the age of eight, and I'm going back to Him who has sent me. Hallelujah. The beauty that I come to find my time and talk to Him, I'm going to leave it behind. The real church will go to God. God was in you. You are the church. You are the church. No wonder the Bible says, when two or three are gathered in my name. Now, you can be gathering even in the church. Three of you are gathered together. You are already in the church. Stop looking at beautiful building. Stop looking at what the musical instrument. Stop looking at how the pastor dressed. Think of yourself as the church, as the temple of the living God. Where God says on daily basis. God lives in you on daily basis. And He speaks to you. He talks with you. He gives His direction. You don't know that find a place. There was a woman when he was talking with Jesus and I said, I need to go to Jerusalem to worship God. And trust Jesus. Jesus told her, sorry, you don't need to go to Jerusalem. You are the church. God that you want to go to Jerusalem to talk with is in you. That is why people select where to go and worship. That mentality is wrong. Very wrong. Of course, you must look for a place that you can have, what I mean, a direction, a clear direction about our Lord Jesus Christ. But it's not really the place that matters. It is you that is going to the place. What motive are you having? What attitude are you carrying? Are you going there because the pastor can speak big grammar? Or you are going there because you yourself is the church? You just need there to fulfill the word I said. Do not forbid the assembly of the brethren.
Amen.
If that is your focus, as you move, God Himself is with you.
Amen.
And trust God. He said His word. Wherever you go to, if you abide in me and my word abide in you, ask whatsoever you need and I will give it unto you.
Amen.
Stop looking at the buildings. Stop looking at the structure of the building of the church. You are the church. Make it right now. Make it right now. Cleanse yourself and let God come in. There's no man on earth that God does not speak to. Every single woman, God speaks to them. Depends on the ear that you have to hear the word of truth. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise Master Jesus.
Hallelujah.
People of God, let not be deceived. God is not much. God is the God that can talk to anyone, anytime. Depends on the preparation of your mind. Depends on the preparation of your mind. Amen.
Amen.
If the church must progress, that is not the business of God. It's your business. Because you are the church. God has given you an assignment. God has given you an assignment. He has given you all the materials that you need. That is why you have the hands to clap. You have the mouth, the tongue to talk, the mouth to sing, the eyes to read, the ear to hear, elect to walk to the building to worship the Lord. So all the materials you need all together is in you. Now if the church is not moving, the church is sitting in one place, the church is lying in one place, that means you are lying in one place. You need to stand up and run. You need to stand up and talk. You need to stand up and clap. You need to stand up and speak. You need to stand up and sing. If you want to light, join church. Let's get this clear understanding. And stop saying, because the kingdom any just throw me up. I'm not going to the church. If you say you are doing, it's not the best telling. Because she understood that she is her own church. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Don't look at people and begin to discourage on the calling of God in your life. Because at the end of age, every man will stand before God and give account of himself or herself.
Amen.
God is going to ask you, the church I place in you, how do you manage it? There have been a lot of noise in the media. A lot of noise. Church, stop destroying yourself. Church, stop destroying yourself. I was talking with one of my colleagues on Wednesday or Thursday. He asked me, are you a Muslim? I said, no, I'm a Christian. I said, okay, it's good. No, it's good. I said, why do you say so? He said, because I'm starting Ramadan very soon. So I said, the problem I have is that I can stay without eating, but drinking is from them. I said, the Lord will strengthen you.
Amen.
He said, do you know I'm a terrorist? I said, why? So I begin to be afraid of him. I said, why do you say so? He said, yes. Everybody in the world believes that Muslim is a terrorist. He said, even my father called me and asked me, are you a terrorist? I said, no, you're a terrorist. He said, I asked him, why do you say so? He said, everybody believes that we are terrorists. Hallelujah. Even as at that, you will never see a Muslim brother stabbing a Muslim brother. The Bible says, if kingdom that divided against itself, it cannot stand. Yes, they are misleading people. Yes, they are twisting the word of God. But if we must make the kingdom of God stand, we must speak the truth. It is only church as a church destroying churches. Muslims cannot fight themselves. If it happens that you are fighting a Muslim man, and you being a Christian, or not even a Christian, but just you are not a Muslim, you are fighting a Muslim man, and another Muslim man side it afar, you see, come to grace. He is not coming to ask, brother, what is going on? Before he knows it, he hits first, and begins to fight the other person. At the end of it all, he is not coming to you, he go to his brother and say, what happened? That one said it was very good, beating already. Hallelujah. Church, stop fighting yourselves. Speak in love. Correct in love. There are so many truths that we say, but we present the truth in the wrong format. That is the problem that the church is having. Church wants to correct church, but the correct church in a wrong format. Not in the proper way. The Bible did not deny correction. It talks about correction. When your brother is going astray, it's your duty to put it right. But do it at the right time, in the right way. There are some truth that is even more worse than lie. You say, you begin to blame yourself. Why did I even say this truth? Because immediately you say this, it's like boom, explode again. So when applying the truth, use wisdom.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We should not destroy the church. When we try to destroy the church, we are destroying ourselves. And now one thing that is dangerous about destroying the church is that it is in itself that is the head of the church. It is that I will build my church and the gate of hell will not prevail. Which means when the gate of hell try to prevail, come. And he said his word called upon me in the days of trouble. Whosoever want to trouble you, because you are the child of God, God arise. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. Don't listen to what people are saying concerning the church. Because if you listen to them, they are condemning church. Knowing rightfully that they are condemning you because you are the church. So therefore, you should not also condemn. If you condemn any church, you are condemning yourself. Because you are the temple of God. You are the church. Where are you sitting here? I stand here. There is no church. Hallelujah. People of God, God followed you. God loves you. That is why he paid a price.
Amen.
You were born with the price.
Amen.
A special price. A price that no other thing is above. Is it above or all?
Amen.
Because he knows that you are his. Because he lives in you. Amen.
Amen.
When the disciples could not understand that they were a child or they can do it themselves, then Jesus told them, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Also believe in me. He went further to tell them and said, don't be afraid. Since I'm going, I know you all are panicking, but I'm going to send you a comforter that will teach you all things. That is the greatest gift that God can give to mankind. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So don't mess up with your body. You are the church of God. You are the church of God. You are the church of God. Let nothing deceive you. Let no man deceive you. Let no woman deceive you. You are the church of God. It is you that God will ask a question. How do you manage the church and place in you? Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Lord Almighty help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's stand up together as we pray.